example. This one is the third presentation on the basis of chapter 3, trigonometric functions. In the previous presentation, we are familiar with how to convert the value, the given angle, from degree to radian or radian to degree. Then we are able to find the values of other trigonometric ratios if one T ratio is given. We know the quadrant rule, which value is positive and which one is negative in which quadrant. And moving ahead in this series, in this presentation, we are going to find out some values of trigonometric function. Angles are given and we are able to find the value of the trigonometric function on the given angle. Then here we have, let us recall, this we know in the first quadrant all the functions, all the T ratios we are getting positive. In the second one, the sine and cosec are positive and rest of the values, the other four T ratios are negative. In the third quadrant, the value of tan theta and cot theta, means the value of tangent and cotangent, we are getting positive. And rest of the four values are negative. In the fourth one, cos and sec are positive and rest of the values are negative. This chart, we are familiar about this chart. In the previous presentation also we have discussed this, in which quadrant which T ratio is positive. If you are observing here again, then in the first one all the T ratios we are observing positive. Then this one is remaining in the last presentation, the domain and range of the function. In the previous presentation, we have discussed about the graph of the trigonometric functions. And we are putting the value of x. If the function you are taking as y equal to sine x, you are putting the value of x and we are getting the value of y. And on keeping on plotting that point xy coordinate on the graph paper, easily we are getting the graph of the functions, trigonometric functions. Then here if you are observing, then domain of the T ratio sine and cos, we are observing these are real number. And on these value, if you are finding the range, then the value we are getting in between minus 1 and 1. Not more than this, not less than this. Not less than minus 1 and not more than 1. This you have to remember. Same for cos x. The domain is real number. We are putting the any real number and we are getting the value. And that value lies always in between minus 1 and 1. It may be equal to minus 1 and 1. Tan x, what we know about tan x? Tan x is sin x upon cos x. And if the value sin x upon cos x, and what we know, if the denominator becomes 0, then we are getting the condition of not defined, 1 upon 0 condition we are getting. And if you are getting this condition, then that we are not able to find. For this reason, if you are observing the domain of tan x, then one value is remaining, and that is 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. Because cos 90 or the multiple of that, we are getting the value 0 and denominator should not be 0. For this reason, we are eliminating this value from the domain, 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. And range we are getting as all the real number. Same for cosec x. Cosec x is equal to 1 upon sin x. And if denominator you are getting 0, when you are getting denominator 0, if the value of x you are taking 0, then sin 0 is 0 and you are getting 1 upon 0 condition. For this reason, if you are observing the cosec x domain, then we are removing one value and that is n pi. Because sin 0 we are getting 0, sin 180 we are getting 0, sin 360 we are getting 0. It means that the multiple of pi, if you are putting the value of x as the multiple of pi, then the value of cosec we are getting not defined. For this reason, from the domain we are removing this n pi, and the range we are getting, except this value, rest of the real numbers we are getting as the range. Same for sec x. Sec x is reciprocal of cos x. Then again we are removing here वन वैल्यू टू एन प्लस वन इंटू पाई बाई टू, एंड फॉर द कॉटेक्स कॉटेक्स इज इक्वल टू कॉस एक्स अपॉन साइन एक्स. इट मीन्स डैट साइन द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन एक्स शुड नॉट बी जीरो, एंड इफ यू आर टेकिंग द मल्टीपल ऑफ पाई देन वी आर गेटिंग दिस वैल्यू जीरो एंड द कंडीशन ऑफ नॉट डिफाइन. देन वॉट वी आर डूइंग हेयर फ्रॉम द डोमेन वी आर रिमूविंग दिस वैल्यू एन पाई एंड द रेंज वी आर गेटिंग रियल नंबर. दिस यू हैव टू रिमेंबर, दिस इज वेरी हेल्पफुल इन सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चन, इन टेलिंग द लिमिट, इन फाइंडिंग द आंसर्स. देन हियर वी हैव, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द क्वेश्चन यू हैव टू लर्न दीज वैल्यूज, एंड दीज वैल्यूज आर ऑलमोस्ट यूज इन ऑल द क्वेश्चन. देन लेट अस गो थ्रू दिस. The value of sine 0, the value of sine 0 we are getting 0. Sine 90 in radian, if you are converting this, try to convert all the values which are given into degree in the book, NCERT book, and find out the radian measure of that. Or you may take any value in degree or you may convert this into radian measure. Then sine pi by 2 we are getting 1. Sin pi means sin 180 we are getting 0. Sin 270 we are getting minus 1. The value of sin 360 we are getting 0. This we are observing the values 0 is repeated here. 0, 0, 0 when the angle is 0 degree, when the angle is 180 degree, when the angle is 360 degree. Means if you are go through this concept, then on the x axis if you are finding any value of sine, we are getting 0. Then these angles also, we know some of them. Cos 0 we know it is 1, sine 0 is 0. Cos 90 also we know 0, sine 90 is 1. Cos 180, this one is new for you. Cos 180 is minus 1, you are able to find this by using some concept that we are going to learn, and sine 180 we are getting 0. Cos 270 is 0. These values are periodically repeated. If you are observing, cos 90 is 0, cos 270 is 0. Here if you are observing sine 90 is 1, then sine 270 is minus 1. And why we are getting minus sign? Due to the quadrant in which it lie. Then cos 360, cos 360 we are getting 1. Cos 0 if you are observing, we are getting 1. Cos 180 minus 1. Cos 360 1. Same for this. Then a similar pattern we are observing. The values are periodically repeated. It means that if you know the basic value, then we are able to find the multiple of that angle. Then here if you are observing, this we have, if I am taking minus theta, and now we are going to write the values of all the t ratios for this angle minus theta. If you are observing the point P is in first quadrant, and the angle you are getting with the x-axis as theta, and P dash if you are observing, then it is at the angle minus theta. Then if you are finding the value of sin theta in this fourth quadrant, minus theta here if you are observing, then sin minus theta what we are getting, then again it is perpendicular upon hypotenuse, and perpendicular up here we are observing m dash p dash, and hypotenuse we are observing as op dash, and m dash p dash is negative of MP, and this concept we are using here for finding the values of T ratio. Then sine minus theta we are getting as the ratio of M dash P dash upon OP dash perpendicular upon hypotenuse, and this value is equal to minus MP upon OP, means sine minus theta we are getting the value as minus sine theta. When you are finding cos minus theta in that triangle, then we are getting as cos theta. 10 minus theta, we are getting minus 10 theta. All these you have to remember. Sine minus theta, if suppose you are getting sine minus 30 degree means pi by 6, then sine minus pi by 6 is equal to minus sine pi by 6, the value of sine minus pi by 6 means minus, and sine 30 degree we know 1/2, then minus 1/2 is the answer for the question. Principal value these are. Then similarly cosec minus theta, this is mistaken here, cosec minus theta is minus cosec theta, and sec minus theta is sec theta plus sec theta, because cos is positive then sec is positive. Sin we are getting negative means cosec is also negative. If sin is negative then we are getting 10 negative, and if 10 is negative then the reciprocal of 10 is cot, that is also negative. Then here I am taking the angle as angle in the first quadrant, and that angle I am taking as 90 minus theta. If you are subtracting any angle from the 90, we are getting that value in first quadrant. Then here if you are observing and you are finding the values, then what we know, all these values are positive. Sine is positive in the first, sine, cos 10, all these 6 trigonometric ratios are positive. Then these value we are getting, sin 90 minus theta is cos theta, this we have already done in class 10th also. Cos 90 minus theta sin, 10 90 minus theta cot, cot 90 minus theta 10 theta, sec 90 minus theta cosec theta, means the complementary t ratio we are getting here. The complementary of sin we are getting cos, the complementary of cos we are getting sin, complementary of 10 is cot, complementary of cot is 10, complementary of sec is cosec, and cosec is sec. What happen if you are taking 90 plus theta, then the theta lies in second quadrant, and if it lies in second quadrant, then what we know, only the value of sine and cosec is positive and rest of the values we are getting negative. By using the right angle triangle you are able to find all these values, and the proof of these, then this we are getting sine 90 plus theta we are getting as cos theta. Cos 90 plus theta we are getting minus sin theta, 10 90 plus theta is minus cot, and if you are observing these, then the values of only cosec and sin, these two values are positive and rest of the values are negative in the second quadrant. What we are observing here, if you are taking the value on y-axis, then the complementary property is come into existence. Transformation we are getting here on the y-axis means sine become cos, cos become sine, and if you are finding the value on the x-axis, on the horizontal axis, then we are not getting any transformation, and this we are going to observe here. If I am taking 180 minus theta, then this value also lies in second quadrant, 180 minus theta, but what we are observing, we are not getting the transformation here. If you are finding the value sin 180 minus theta, we are getting sin theta. Only this value is also lying in second quadrant, it means that only sin and cosec are positive and rest of the values are negative, and this we are observing here. Cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta, 10 180 minus theta we are getting minus 10 theta, and cot becomes cot, sec becomes sec. We are not getting the transformation here if you are finding the value on the horizontal axis, the x-axis. And if you are observing these, then 180 plus theta, then this angle lies in third quadrant, and in the third quadrant only the 10 and cot we are getting positive and rest of the values are negative. Then sin 180 plus theta we are getting minus sin theta, and cos 180 plus theta minus cos. Transformation will not take place because we are taking the value from the x-axis. 180 lies on the x-axis. If you are observing this, then this we are taking as 0 degree, then here you are getting 90. Here you are getting 180, and here you are getting 370, 3 pi upon 2. then similarly so on. If you are adding 90 degree angle, you are getting the next value what we are getting. Then if you are 0, then 2 pi we are getting, pi, then here we are getting 3 pi, 5 pi, 7 pi, so on, and here we are getting 2 pi, 4 pi on this value. Then this you have to remember, the transformation will not take place when we are taking the value from the x-axis, and it will take place when we are taking the value on y-axis. And the quadrant rule you have to remember, which t ratio is positive in which quadrant. Then here we are observing the same. If you are finding 270 minus theta, then 270 minus theta, this value is also lies in third quadrant, or only the value of 10 and cot is positive here. Then sine 270 minus theta transformation will take place, then it becomes cos minus cos theta. Cos 270 minus theta, it becomes minus sine theta. But when we are finding for 10 theta, we are getting plus cot theta. And same for the cot, we are getting plus 10 theta. For the sec, we are getting minus cos sec. Transformation here take place. And if you are finding for 270 plus theta, I mean any angle, if you are adding to 270 degree, then we are in the fourth quadrant. And in the fourth quadrant, the value of cos and sec, these two values are positive and rest of the values are negative. Then if you are observing here, then transformation will take place. This value, we are 270, we are taking from the y-axis. Then sine 270 plus theta, we are getting as minus cos theta. The value of sine, we are getting negative, and transformation take place. Cos 270 plus theta, we are getting plus sine theta. The value of cos and sec is positive. If you are observing the value of cos and sec, then these values are positive. And rest of the values, we are getting negative, and the transformation will take place. Then here, if you remember the table of class 10th, then further in this series, in class 10th, we have the table up to 90 degree angle. Now this time we are expanding this, and for 180, 270 and 360 here I have. Then sine 180 degree is 0, cos 180 is minus 1, and tan 180 we are getting 0. Sine 270 we are getting minus 1, cos 270 is 0, and tan 270 is not defined, because cos is 0 and tan is sine upon cos. If the value of sine and cos we have, we are able to find the value of 10x. The same concept we have, which we have already learnt in class 10th, how to get the angles, how to get the values on the given angle. Sine 360 degree, you have to remember this, this is 0. And cos 360 we are getting 1. Sin 360 is 0 and cos 360 is 1. Then tan 360 we are getting 0. Let us solve a question. And here I have the question. We have to find the value of tan 19 pi upon 3. Yes, this angle is in radian and we have to find this value. Then we are able to write 19 pi by 3 as 6 pi plus pi by 3. If you are taking LCM, then we are getting 6 into 3 as 18 pi plus pi, means 19 pi upon 3 we are getting. It means that 19 pi upon 3 is written as 10, 6 pi plus pi by 3. And 6 pi is written as 3 into 2 pi. 2 pi means 360 degree, 360 into 3 means the value we are taking on the x-axis. Then whether the transformation will take place or not? No, because the value is lies in first quadrant. And the value we are getting positive because all the t ratios are positive in the first quadrant, and transformation will not take place here. Then if you are using the concept, then 10 3 into 2 pi plus pi by 3, and if you are using this concept, tan 360 into n plus theta we are getting as tan theta, then directly we are getting the value as tan pi by 3. And the value of tan pi by 3 we know. Pi by 3 means 60 degree, tan 60 we know 1 root 3. Then the answer we are getting as root 3 here. This is the principal value for tan 19 pi upon 3. 1 marks question we are getting on the basis of these. Let us solve one more question, and in this question this is given. We have to prove this cos 510 degree into cos 330 degree plus sin 390 degree into cos 120 degree is equal to minus 1. Then how to solve this? Then we are reducing these angle to the angle on which the values we know. Then cos 510. 510 is written as 90 into 5 plus 60. Means 450 plus 60. 510 is written as 450 plus 60. Then which quadrant it lie? It lie in the second quadrant. And if it lie in the second quadrant, then in the second quadrant the value of cos is negative. Then we are getting minus sin 60 degree there. The value of cos 510 we are getting as minus sin 60 degree. If you are observing the second one, cos 330 degree. Cos 330 degree, either you are writing this as 360 degree minus 30 degree, or you may write, if you are writing in the multiples of 90, then 330 degree is written as 270 plus 60 degree, we are getting 330 degree. Then in which quadrant this lie? This lie in fourth quadrant, because it is less than 360. And if it lies in the fourth quadrant, then the value of cos is positive there, but transformation will take place. Then this we are getting as sin 60 degree. Moving ahead, if you are observing this value, sin 390 degree. 390 means 360 plus 30. We are able to write this. And 360 plus 30 means this value lies in first quadrant and all the values are positive and transformation will not take place. Then what we are getting? We are getting sin 30. For the last one, cos 120 degree, then cos 120 is written as 90 plus 30. And if you are finding 90 plus 30, then this value lies in second quadrant and there the value of cos is negative. For this reason we are getting minus sin 30 degree. And transformation will also take place. Then on solving, because we know these values, sin 60, sin 30, then if you are putting all these values, then what we are getting? Sin 60 is root 3 by 2 and sin 30 is 1 by 2. Then if you are solving this, then we are getting root 3 into root 3 as 3, 2 into 2 as 4 means 3 by 4, and 1 into 1 is 1 and 2 into 2 is 4. Means minus 3 by 4 minus 1 by 4. On solving these or by taking the LCM, we are getting the value as minus 1. Then I hope you are able to find these trigonometric values if the angle is given by using this concept. And on the basis of these, you have to solve the questions which are remaining in the exercise. And the questions are 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Question number 8 I have done. Rest of the question you have to solve. Sairam to